Yeah. Most often, when we're done with school, the next thing we want to do is to work. But the question is, what is the motive behind the nature and kind of work we want to do? Do we really understand the dynamics of working? Are we working because we need to work, or we working because it's a service we need to render and make a living? If you don't get it right, you might lose the kind of motivation you need that will get you focused and glued to work and make sure you succeed with it. If you approach work with the attitude of I'm providing a service to make a living, you might get it wrong. You might lose that kind of focus, motivation that will urge you on even in time of difficulty. But if you approach work with a view that you need to work, you derive a lot of motivation. Even in down times, you derive a lot of motivation to get you up and keep moving, because you understand why you need to work. Now, we're going to use the Maslow's hierarchy of needs to illustrate and find out why we need to work, so that we can adopt that approach in our lifetime, in the work field, when engaged in anything, and that can be a driving force to push us ahead and get us even stronger when we face challenges in life, so that we don't go approach work with a view that we're offering a service just to make a living. So with the Maslow's hierarchy of needs in life, the first stage is to think about the physiological needs in life. Now, with the physiological needs in life, you are talking about the basic needs in life that are unavoidable. So, for instance, you cannot live without water. Water is a must to life. Food is a must to life. Shelter is a must to life. All right? Emotional needs are must to life. You cannot do away with these things, and so they become part and parcel of your livelihood. Right. If you cannot do with these things and you still have to live and exist on this earth, what do you need to do? And you cannot acquire and have all these things on a silver platter. You need money. And if you need money, how do you raise the money? It means you need to work. Because you want to achieve all these things at this level in life, having the basic needs in life, and it requires money, that tells you that you need to work. And it doesn't become like just offering a service to make a living. Where is the motivation? By having a focus to this, you know you need to work, and so it pushes you to make sure you have to work. Gain this. Now, there are various levels and stages you go through in your lifetime. And so at every stage in life, you want to move to the next level. And all this requires money. So the next level we're going to stop at is your safety needs in life. In terms of your safety needs in life, you want to look at your future security, your present security. You want to look at how comfortable you want your life to be, and what are the measures and investments you need to put in place to ensure you have a safety, secured life to live for yourself, your family, and all your dependents. Okay, so you want to go into investments, properties, having all that you require, social security, okay, life insurance policies and all that. You're putting all that in place to make life more comfortable and secure for you. So when you swing around, you can remember that, hey, I have something here to cushion me up here and there. So you put in a lot of investment to ensure your safety in life. Now, the next level you want to look at is having love and companionship or belonging. Alright? You want to feel belong, because you've achieved these two levels in life. And so, you want to feel belong. You want to feel loved. You want to feel cared for. You want to belong to certain groups and certain associations to feel, you are really somebody. You also belong to that lifestyle of people, or you know, you just want to feel comfortable to realize that yeah, you are steadily really moving on. And so that aspect comes up. All right, so you find yourself associating here and there and feeling welcome. You want to feel that everybody should really recognize that you are also one of those things. So that inner aspect satisfaction, you want to achieve it. Now you then move to the next level where we call esteem. All right, you've gotten to that state in life that you feel you've got it all. All right, you've got it all, you are there, and that is the stage when you don't take care, ego and pride could roll you out. All right, you've achieved it, you've gotten to that self-esteem stage, and you feel nobody can rub it up with you. You are just there alone, and so you want to look down on people if you don't take care at that level. These are some of the characteristic traits that might get into you. But you rather at that stage want to impact the next generation. You've gone through a lot of stages, a lot of experience, you have a lot of knowledge, and you rather want to impact the next generation, get them, train them to reduce their learning curves. Okay, so it should be more of an impactful stage, even as you've realized what you've achieved and how comfortable life is for you. You want to rather make sure you impact, bless, support, help, get other people to also rise up and move on, rather than wanting to lord it over them. Okay, so the self-esteem stage. Then you want to get to what? Self-actualization. At this level, it's like, I've got it all. You've got all the physiological needs in place. You've got the safety needs in place. You've got the love and belonging, companionship levels covered. You've got your self-esteem. You've really gotten to the actualization stage where you know at this level, all I need is gone. All I need, I have. I mean, you want to get to the stage of experimenting in heavy investments, all right? Taking higher risk just to want to explore your dream life. Okay, you've got it all. What next? All right? So for you to get through all these stages requires money. And how do you raise that money? It requires that you need to work. All right, so have the attitude of you need to work, and not I have to work and just get paid or offer a service as if you're doing it for somebody. No, you're doing it for yourself. And so let's get motivated to understand why we need to work and let that edge us on. Even in times of difficulties and challenges, we will be able to sail through. Okay, these are some of the educative materials Cecil Entrepreneurial Session has put in place to try to use to support startup entrepreneurs, upstart entrepreneurs, and prospective entrepreneurs, to guide them, to help them strengthen themselves within their entrepreneurial spaces, get them to succeed, and together we shall be able to pull our nation together as one and shall all succeed and leverage on it to achieve our heights in life. And so this is what I have for you. Take care and learn and grow your business. Bye.